Hello, I'm Gary Barnett, historical musicology student here in the PhD program at the University of California Riverside Music Department. I'm studying Carillon here at the University of California. This will be my second lesson, and waiting for my teacher to come on over and begin my next lesson.
Hi Gary, good to see you
again. Hi David, nice to meet you.
And we'll have our next lesson.
Sounds great.
Gary, last week I asked you to practice this song on page 25 of the instruction book. How have you done on it?
Well, okay. I mean, this is my first time, and I made it here in the tower. It's a little bit...
You practiced down in the practice room, I suppose, quite a bit.
Right. Before I came up.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, last week we did go over the theme, but it was a little bit too much to ask you to play the whole thing, being a theme and variations. But you're ready to do it today, I think. Mm-hmm. Did you have any difficulties with it at all?
I think the main difficulty for now is how far the keys are. See, on a piano, of course, or an organ or whatnot, they're so close, and I can play them all with my fingers, but. Getting the spatial relationships of these distances.
Right, right.
I can read the notes, of course, but how do I relate that?
And that might even come into play even more when you have to play very high up on the batons and very low, the spatial relationships.
We'll see if I can do that on the last variation, because it's all in this place octaves.
Okay. And on the second to the last one, too, be careful when you get here to this one, because the melody is going to be in the left hand. You're going to have a descant in the right hand.
We'll have to voice
there,
that.
So you want to be sure that you let the melody come out, because the parts are pretty close together. Chance to work on that a little bit during the week?
I did work on it.
Okay.
And one of the difficulties that I encountered is that voicing the melody in the lower range of the carillon, the keys are a little bit more, I guess they're bigger bells and they're a little more sluggish.
The clappers are larger and have more weight to them. So
I found that voicing the melody as well as these two was a little bit more tricky in that respect.
Okay. Well, let's have you try this short little variation of the piece you just played and see how it works out.
Okay. I'll take it maybe a little slower tempo.
Okay. section of the book.
Yes.
You've had these intervals in the right hand, but what do you do if you have, say, a 3 or 4 note chord to play, or maybe even more notes than that? There's a technique here that he shows you breaking the chords that is sometimes desirable to do. You may not need to do it all the time, but here we have an F major chord. Now, you could just play it like this.
Right.
But if you're going to arpeggiate the chord, you do it like this. So, depending on the context and the music and various factors, you may do it one way or the other. Now, here we have some 4-note chords. So, this shows you the technique of playing those chords in that particular way. Let's have you try a little bit of this first one here.
Okay.
And this again is something you'll be working on a little bit more during the week.
And it's interesting how they notate these arpeggiations.
Well, normally they don't write it out like this. He's just showing you how to do it in the book.
And this little diagonal slash, that's the indication for this particular type of roll?
That's the particular indication that he uses in this book.
I see. Okay. Starting with the middle note of the triad first. Okay. Mm-hmm. I'll do it a little slow.
Okay. That's a little slow, and you want to do it a little quicker as you get used to it. Okay, I think that's going to finish us up for this week's lesson.
Thank you.
I think you're going to have enough to focus on for the coming week.
Yes.
One of the areas you'll be working on here is page 40.
Okay.
We'll incorporate some of the things.
Now, can I ask you, when will I be able to actually start using the pedals?
Let's not rush into it.
Okay.
We will be doing that in just a couple more weeks.
Okay.
I want you to focus a little bit more on the manuals first,
And
then we will be adding the pedals.
Well, could I ask you just a little favor at the tail end of our lesson?
Sure.
Could I have you just play a little bit of something maybe that has some pedal work in it?
Let me see what I have up here. You've been doing some study in the music of Portugal, haven't you? Isn't that part of your area of study? Wasn't there a particular composer?
Yes, I'm actually focusing on the life and works of the Baroque composer Carlos Seixas.
I have a piece of his up here.
Oh, you're kidding.
It's a little minuet from one of his sonatas. Let me see if I have it here.
Oh, I would just love that.
Yeah, here it is.
Oh, that's fabulous. Thank you.
And, it's a simple two-part little piece, but it does use the pedals. In fact, this is probably a piece that I'm going to give you in just a few weeks.